So this is the device that can warp you out of a dungeon. This is basically exposition that enables a gameplay mechanic. That's all this is. So, I'm going to turn on the Lhasa button. Yeah, okay. Alright, I'm going to turn on the map and radar. This helps me find treasure chests hidden around a town and out in the wilderness and whatnot. Here. There's a few in town. This is a really complicated town the first time you come through. Like, it took me a while to learn it. I mean, I still kind of get caught up in dead ends every now and then, but it is a complicated town. It reminds me of Windia from Breath of Fire 3. Very complicated town. Easy to get lost in. Easy to find yourself in dead ends. I see a chest back there. There we go. Berries. There's a lot of NPCs to talk to here. Okay, so this is kind of like the tutorial. Like the hangout for the tutorial NPCs. I don't know what you'd call it. There's a place kind of like this in Final Fantasy VII where you learn about like materia and all that. But these people run you through some stuff. Are you looking for something? Yeah, okay. Can't find any books about magic. So that was kind of an anti-tutorial. It told you about something, but didn't tell you anything, like, about it. I know how magic works, though. You find a book, you read it, and then the relevant character learns the spell. It's not that tricky. Fight strategy? Sure. I already know how this goes. I'll talk about it later. I'll get through this tutorial here. Well, you'll see. Alright. So you see to the right, there's that this kind of equal sign. There's the top part and the bottom part. The bottom part of that equal sign is lit up, which means that this attack works on ground-based enemies. If the higher part was lit up, then that means that the attack works on flying enemies. If both are lit up, then it works on anybody. So I wasn't really paying attention. I know it was a ground-based attack, but I don't know if they want me to try to use it on this guy or not. So they can tell me, like, well, this is what you did wrong. We'll try. Counterattack. Select defense, and see if you can counterattack. Make sure you defend yourself. He said something about moving back, so we'll do that. Defend now. Defend Edisot. This guy has to teach. Oh, energy gathering. Yeah, we'll go ahead and run through this. Alina and Edisot. Gather. Okay. Attacking the amoeba with the aqua arrow. This guy, right? Yes. So use the fireball spell. And Alina gives me the gather. The gather system is pretty cool. It kind of just, it multiplies like the functionality of everything, damage, spells, healing spells too. Like you name it, if it's a thing, the gather probably functions to increase its effectiveness. The only downside, really, is that you have to kind of take a turn to do it. But, you know, like you saw in that tutorial, though, you can share gather. So, I mean, you could have your weak enemies in the back just using gather over and over again and give it to the people up front, like in the front lines. So that's a good strategy. It really only comes into play, like, you really only need to worry about it for, like, boss fights. Most battles you can kind of just get by with basic attacks. I feel like there's... feel like there's at least one more chest somewhere. I could be wrong. Yeah. Maybe there's one inside one of these houses. Oh, this is Edisat's proper house. This is where his parents live. If this guy would move, yeah, here we go. Let's see, we have this thing in the menu here, notebook. It kind of gives us a clue as to what to do. It says, we need to hurry up to get the herbs. Let's go to the forest. All right, so what kind of money do I have? 400. I'm kind of wondering if maybe I should buy some armor or something before I head out. Or a new weapon or something. Let's see here. Iron sword. Yeah, we'll pick that up. +2. Let's see. I think I could probably walk out of here with all of these. I should probably save some of my money for armor, but whatever. Let's sell some of the old junk then. Sell the dagger. Pocket knife. I didn't catch how much money I had left over. 64. Probably not enough to get any armor, but I'm not really too concerned about right now. Though I probably should be. I probably could have spent my money a lot more wisely. But that's okay. All you gotta do to get more is go to the forest and grind for a while. Okay, so instead of having like a traditional JRPG, like 16-bit JRPG overworld, we have kind of like a menu-based overworld. You just pick out kind of where you want to go. I'll show you the farm. There's kind of a cool Easter egg in the farm. So you know the company that made this game is called Watermelon. So keep that in mind as we talk to these people. Watermelon, Citrullus lanatus, actually belongs to the same plant family as cucumber. Considering it actually contains 90% water, it has a very fitting name. The other 10% is quite nutritious, especially in vitamin C. And she's repeating herself. There's someone else. Hey kids, take a look at this farm. Hey kids! Watermelons, they look beautiful. Indeed they do. I was